Hi, I'm Lawrence Chang, Senior Product Manager for App Indexing at Google. In this session, I'm going to give you an overview of the App Indexing API and how to use it. Now, App Indexing is a capability of Google Search that helps users find and access content in native apps, just like websites. For an app developer, App Indexing provides you with an opportunity to drive engagement of your app through Google. The App Indexing API extends this opportunity even further. First, while App Indexing provides you ways to specify link mappings through website markup and sitemaps, the App Indexing API provides a third option that you can use to specify app links, in this case, through apps themselves. Second, while App Indexing adds app deep links to search results, the App Indexing API adds app deep links to query autocompletions. The autocompletions are personalized and shown to users based on app content that they've engaged with before, so it can help users re-engage with your app. To get started with the App Indexing API, first, your app needs to support deep linking. You can follow our guidelines for how to do this. Then, we recommend you also follow our general App Indexing guidelines as needed. This includes connecting your website to your app. You can read more about that in our developer guide. After you've completed these steps, then start thinking about the App Indexing API. So let's get into some more details. First, you need to add Google Play services to your app if you haven't already. To do this, add a line to your manifest file to get the right version of Google Play services. Then, if you're using Android Studio, you'll also need to add a dependency in your build file. Finally, get the latest version of Google Play services through the SDK manager. Then, in your main activity, you import the App Index and App Indexing link classes. Next, you define a global Google API client, and in onCreate, you instantiate it. In onStart, you connect your client and define both the app address and the corresponding web address of the page. Now, in this example, I'm showing you the actual links as strings, but in reality, you would likely programmatically create these links with variables and parameters. Then, you define the outbound links on the page, including both app and web addresses. Now, once you've defined your outbound links, you create app indexing link objects by providing the app address, web address, and the view ID. Then, you create a list out of these links. Next, define a title for your current page. This title is what users will see in the autocompletion UI. Now, you're ready to call the App Indexing API view method. You provide as arguments the Google API client, the activity, the app link, title, web link, and list of outbound links you just created. Finally, in onStop, add a call to the viewEnd method and disconnect your client. So to summarize, if you'd like to get the most out of app indexing, you should start with adding the deep link support in your app, then follow our general app indexing guidelines, and finally, implement the App Indexing API. For more information, see our developer guidelines right here. I'm Lawrence Chang. Thanks for watching.